My good fortune is not that I have recovered from mental illness. My good fortune lies in having found my life. Hello everyone, welcome. I'm Desma Astia, and today I would like to bring you a walkthrough what we know and don't know from the symptoms, causes, and treatments of schizophrenia. Schizophrenia was first identified more than a century ago, but we still don't know its exact causes. It remains one of the most misunderstood and stigmatized illness today. According to the American National Alliance on Mental Illness, or NAMI, schizophrenia is a severe brain disorder that interferes with a person's ability to think clearly, manage emotions, make decisions, and relate to others. Schizophrenia means split, and phrenia in this case refers to the mind. Even though schizophrenia can be interpreted to mean splitting of the mind, it doesn't refer to a split personality. But schizophrenia can be described as scattered or fragmented pattern of thinking. Although schizophrenia can occur at any age, the average age tends to be in the late teens and the early 20s for men, and the late 20s and the early 30s for women. It is uncommon for schizophrenia to be diagnosed in a person younger than 12 and older than 40. Schizophrenia actually a syndrome, meaning there's all sorts of symptoms that may be associated with it, and different patients might experience different symptoms. The symptoms can be categorized into three major areas: positive symptoms, negative symptoms, and cognitive symptoms. In the positive symptoms, there are hallucinations, delusions, disorganized speech, and disorganized or catatonic behavior. The first one is hallucinations. These include a person hearing voices, seeing things, and smelling things others can perceive. And then delusions. These are false beliefs that don't change even though the person who holds them presented with new ideas or facts. And then the third one is disorganized speech. These include a person have difficulty concentrating and maintaining their thoughts, which manifest in the way they speak. And then the last one is about disorganized or catatonic behavior. The symptoms can be vary from being childlike or being silly and aggressive to violent. The next one is negative symptoms. Negative symptoms are the ones that diminish person's abilities. Negative symptoms often include being emotionally flat or speaking in a dull or disconnected way. People with negative symptoms may be unable to start or follow through with activities, show little interest in life, and also sustain relationship. Negative symptoms are sometimes confused with clinical depression. The last one is cognitive issue or disorganized thinking. Person with the cognitive symptoms often struggle to remember things, organize thoughts, and also complete tasks. Commonly, people with schizophrenia have anosognosia or lack of insight. This means the person is unaware that he has illness that can make treating and working with him much more challenging. The next one is about causes. Research suggests that schizophrenia might have several possible causes. The first one is genetics. Schizophrenia isn't caused by just one genetic variation, but a complex interplay of genetic and environmental influences. And then the second one is about environment. Exposure to viruses or malnutrition before birth can increase the risk of schizophrenia. The third one is about brain chemistry. Problems with certain brain chemicals, including neurotransmitter called dopamine or glutamate, can increase the risk of schizophrenia. The last one, or the fourth one, is about substance use. Some studies have shown that taking drugs can increase the risk of schizophrenia. The next one is about treatment. There's no cure for schizophrenia, but it can be treated or managed in several ways. The first one is antipsychotic medications. Antipsychotic can be very effective to reducing symptoms, but you have to consider the several side effects. The second one is psychotherapy. It is important to combine the medicine with professional therapy or counseling. The third one is self-management strategies and education. It is important to have education about schizophrenia for patients, their families, and their communities to help erode the stigma and improve access to treatment. How about schizophrenia in Indonesia? Mental health problems is a serious issue in Indonesia. One of the most discrimination toward people with mental disorder is the practice of pasung. Many people here still think that schizophrenia is caused by demon possession or black magic. Family members who don't know about this will be pressured to take the patient to dukun or shaman to be exorcised, which almost always results in disaster for all concerned. And how to reduce the stigma? The first one is think about your own feeling about mental illnesses. The second one is about beware of the language. Avoid using the words that can be hurtful, like psycho or crazy. The third one is learn and explore more about mental health from trusted websites. Maybe that's all I have explained about the symptoms, causes, then the treatments, and I also give you bonus about schizophrenia in Indonesia and how to reduce stigma. Maybe that's all. Thank you.